down upon your knees. Okay. Now, we've been doing this for a couple of weeks, on and off. I'm going to do some humming with you to begin with today. Loads of us have got problems with the sinuses. I've talked to so many people at the moment with colds and COVID and what have you. So quite often what you find is you get tightness around the sinuses. So the humming is said to help clear those passages. All right, now you're very much in your own home, okay? So you can do this or don't do it, I don't mind. I'm going to hum up and down in scales, okay? So I'm going to guide you, I'm going to do it with you, if you're doing it with me. And then hopefully that afterwards you should feel that the breath work that we do sitting down is a little bit easier, okay? Let me know at the end, all right? So I'm just going to do as always, let the hands just rest upon the knees. And you might want to do this with your eyes shut, or you can keep your eyes open and have a look at everybody else. So I'm going to take that slow hum coming up. Thank you. our chin back up and breathing in and out. Hopefully now you can feel a little more depth to your breathing. And as we breathe in, let's raise our arms high. As you breathe out, let's take a small rotation with your upper body.
Facing down. Breathe in, draw forwards to a high plank.
to your knees, your belly, your chest. Breathing out, not too much pressure, but gently upward dog. And then breathing in as you power. Curling the toes, engage the core. Breathing out as you push the plank back off into a downward dog. Breathing in, left leg stepping up between your hands, lifting the chin. Breathing out, as lightly step it up with your right foot. Breathing in, drawing all the way back out to a standing position. Breathing out, bring your hands back in towards your heart. Breathing in, raising your arms. Breathing out, dive body forwards. Breathing in, right leg stepping back. Now today, I'd just like you to drop your right heel down on the floor. Breathing in, bring your right arm forwards, breathing out and rolling your back. Breathing in, bring forwards, breathing out over the shoulder and back. Breathing in, reaching in, circle, open up the shoulder. One more time, breathe in. And now sink out the back body, wrapping your arm around the back, looking back over your shoulder. Take a couple of breaths here.
Coming on up to an upward dog. Should find out where the
let's turn the body back round. Place down your left hand to the floor, go to the toes behind you, and raising your right arm up.
Yeah.
bending or for camel today, I'm going to curl the toes up so the heels are a little bit higher, raising the left arm, but then reaching backwards towards your right heel with your right hand and looking back towards it, letting the left arm be a little bit of a weight to draw you slightly open into that bending. And then we'll come through and we'll change. So reaching upwards with your right hand, reaching back with your left hand. Start gently arching it back a little. And let's change it over. Let's go a little bit faster. So we're breathing out to reach back. Breathing in to change. Breathing out to reach back, looking towards your back heel. Breathing in to change. Breathing out to reach back. Breathing in to change. Good. Breathing out, reaching back. Now you can do a couple more if that's really suiting you today. Or you can reach around for your elbows. You can offer your chest upwards towards the ceiling. You can reach along for the back of your legs. Or you can reach down and take your heels. Opening the chest and the throat if that feels good to you. And then chopping your chin, engaging your core. Come gently back on up for me. Sliding the hands ahead. And just again, just covering the position that we really want to hold with our hands. So as you go down, the very middle finger is pointing straight up. And if you can, you want to spread your fingers out as wide as possible to really work through the tendons, so those intricate muscles of your hands. Curl your toes. Send the hips up towards the ceiling. Feet are about hip distance apart as you look back. And then lower your heels as far back as they're willing to go at this point. And you want to really feel in your downward dog that you've got an equal placement between your hands and your feet. Let's take the right leg up towards the ceiling, bend the knee a little. Just take that little bit of opening there for the hip. And then lower it down your leg, lock down the big toe, the toe next to it, the bone above your heel. Forwards into a high plank, looking beyond your feet. halfway up your mat. Crawl up to a high kneel. Now again, we've got a few different layers we can work into here. Deep breath in, raising your left arm. Bring your elbow to the far side of your knee. Maybe place your hands in prayer. Lean forwards, but you're opening up your right armpit. So your arms are pulling nice and open. You may choose to stay here, or you might be able to take your hand down to the floor by the side of your right foot. So left arm will slip over. If you want to take it further, lift up your back knee. And then perhaps here, you could raise back over your right arm. Just gently bending the elbows and lowering down so you find the inner thigh. into your tree, and then working up into dancer. Okay, I'm going to take the same arm as the leg today in dancer. Then from here we can, if you still got the energy, coming into eagle. So opening back through your shoulders, pulling up through your belly, and then slide your right foot either to your calf or above your knee. Pull the arms a little away from the body, if the shoulders are really stiffening, then the shoulders are doing more work than the abdominals and the back are. Alright, so again, you'll be aware of that. Okay, so just try and let them go. Alright, try and be aware that you can do this using the mobility of your back, using the core center, using the hip flexors. And back up. Last one's going down, please stay down. Deep breath in. Breathing out, lowering the body back. And then taking your feet to the floor, reaching around for them, so they're going to touch in distance. Take a deep breath in. As you breathe out, in front of the lower back, peel the spine away from the ground, come on up onto your shoulders. Breathing in. And then breathing out to lower your back down into an imprint and back to neutral. Breathing in. As you breathe out, lifting your hips away from the ground, but try not to clench your buttocks. Breathing in at the top. And then breathing out as you lower your back down, carefully, vertebrae by vertebrae, back to neutral. Breathing in. Breathing out as you ripple through the spine, coming up onto your shoulders. Breathing in, and then breathing out as you lower your back down carefully through imprint and back to neutral. Okay, breathing in, breathing out as you imprint the spine, peeling the back up. Breathing in. Breathing out, engage the core, lower your back carefully into an imprint, back to neutral. One more time, deep breath in, breathing out, peel the spine away from the ground, come on up to your shoulders. Breathing in, and breathing out, lowering your spine carefully. Again, like I say, try not to use your glutes too much. Now, very last position, and I'm going to give you three options. So let's start off with the heel dig, flexing your feet, you've got a neutral spine, and as you lower one heel away from your body, breathe out of your mouth and engage the core, and then breathe in to draw back up. Taking the other heel down, breathe out, draw the navel back to the spine, breathing, come back up nice and slowly. Again, like we did at the beginning, let the breath be even, slow, and in control. So you're breathing out, you're engaging with the core as you dig down, breathing in to come back up. Second version, baby reverse curl. So I'm pointing the toes, I'm taking the hands up into the air. Then, as we lift the hips up, imprint the lower spine, and release. We'll breathe out, engage the core to lift the hips, hold them up, and breathing in to release back down. So here we work the imprint of your lower back, using your abdominals to keep your bottom off the ground, and then slowly let it back. My third layer is a rollover. I place the hands down by your side, the legs towards the ceiling. Breathing in. And then as you breathe out, slowly letting your back peel away from the ground. Breathing in to separate your legs. And then breathing out to slowly lower your back down, vertebrae after vertebrae. And then we bring the legs together at the end. So breathing in, breathing out. We slowly peel the legs upwards. Breathing in to separate the legs. Breathing out to slowly lower all the way back down. All right, last one of whatever you're doing today. Okay, and then just grounding your feet again. Either roll to one side to bring you up. Bring yourself up through the middle. Bringing yourself up to a nice tall seated position. Let's just take your right arm across with your left, with your
Sigh.